previously, when we talked about why do we do sampling, we said that we do sampling when the lot is much bigger and the risk of making wrong judgment is relatively low. So you understand that, when you take sample, there is a chance that you will make a mistake. So when we use acceptance sampling, and remember that initially we took an example of 1000 pieces coming in, we took a sample of 80 pieces, and based on that 80 pieces, we accepted or rejected the lot. When we take sample, we believe that we accept certain level of defects. So you don't do acceptance sampling when your target is to have 100% correct quality level. You do acceptance sampling when you can accept some level of defects. Let's take a simple example that you have set a limit that you will accept anything when the defective items in that particular lot is less than 1.5%. And you will reject the lot if the defective items in that is more than 5%. So what you want to do here is you want to accept any lot which has less than 1.5%. That's fine with you. But then anything which is more than 5%, you want to reject that. And in between these 1.5% and 5%, it's subjective. So it depends on chance. And remember that acceptance sampling is based on chance. As you go further into this course, you will understand that. That you set two limits. Acceptance limit, AQL, acceptable quality limit. Acceptable quality limit is that if quality is better than that, you will straight away accept that. Rejectable quality limit, in this particular example, we said it's 5%. So any case where the quality is poor and you have more than 5% defectives, you want to reject this lot. And in between that, there is a chance, there is a probability of accepting this lot or rejecting this lot. Because you know what? What you are doing is you are taking sample. Sometimes you might get a good sample. Sometimes you might get a bad sample. So depending on that, there is a chance that a good lot might get rejected or a bad lot might get accepted. This is where comes the topic of errors in acceptance sampling. Let's take here, you have two types of lots which you decided. Good lot is where defective rate is less than 1.5%. Bad lot is where the defective rate is greater than 5%. In between that, I still leave that to chance. Your lot might get accepted, your lot might get rejected. Now, once you take some sample out of this lot, and based on that, you decide to accept or reject this lot. Let's say you had a good lot, which actually had less than 1.5% defective. That was a good lot. When you take sample out of that, and you find out that yes, there are not many defectives. So the defectives in that particular lot is less than 1.5%. Based on sample, you judge that and then you accept that lot. That is a correct decision. That's fine. It was a good lot, you accepted that. On the other hand, this was a bad lot having a lot of defectives, more than 5% defectives, and you rejected that lot based on the sample. This one is also fine. These are the two right cases. But then error comes when you had a good lot, which was less than 1.5% defective, but then you rejected that lot. If you rejected that lot, that means this lot will go back to the producer. Means this is a producer's risk. This is also called as type 1 error. Type 1 error is producer's risk. Producer risk comes when producer has made a good quality lot, but just because of chance, just because of sample, this lot got rejected. On the other hand, there could be another case where the lot was bad. Lot had 5% or more than 5% defectives, but somehow the samples which you picked, you somehow picked the good samples and that lot got accepted. So if that lot got accepted means, now this is buyer's risk because buyer has purchased the lot which had lot of defectives. This is called as type 2 errors. So these are the two types of error which can happen when you use acceptance sampling. So let's summarize this in the form of a table here. So we have type 1 error, which is producer's risk, and type 2 error is consumer's risk. Type 1 error is called as alpha, and type 2 error is called as beta. So this is the sign. Alpha is shown as like this, beta is shown as like this. Let's talk about type 1 error. And type 1 error was producer's risk. Producer has made a good lot but somehow got rejected. This is also called as a false alarm. So to understand these, which one is which, I use that type 1 error is a false alarm. False alarm that even though everything was fine, but that raised a false alarm that the lot is defective and we rejected this lot and that led to producer's risk. Another example of that could be fire in the building. So you have a building, you have fire alarms. Sometimes you get fire alarms even though there is no fire. That is also type 1 risk or alpha or the producer's risk because this is a false alarm. What could happen in that case? This could cause you inconvenience that you need to leave building and fire brigade will come, they will check and then they will tell that everything is fine and then you will find out that this was a false alarm. On the other hand, the beta error will be where you missed that fire. So there was a fire but fire alarm didn't sound and then the whole building was on fire. So risk in that case is much bigger. This could lead to a disaster. The building could burn down. And how do we control that? In case of alpha or the producer's risk or the type 1 error, there are usually a fixed predetermined level. So you have a 1%, 5% or 10%. 1% is also shown as 0.01, 5% is shown as 0.05 and 10% is shown as 0.10. You already decide that beforehand that this is the type 1 error we want to have in our acceptance sampling plan or even any sampling plan. And what about type 2 error? Type 2 error is usually controlled by changing the sample size. So if you want to change the beta error or a type 2 error, you change the sample size, make it bigger and then you will have a less of beta error. In case of court judgment, when a criminal comes to court, when innocent is declared as guilty, this is type 1 error. Type 1 error is producer's risk or the innocent getting declared as guilty, and type 2 error will be when guilty is declared as innocent. So now with this basic understanding of risks involved in acceptance sampling, that you can make error, you can make type 1 error, you can make type 2 error. Now let's move on to acceptance sampling, learn about few terms in acceptance sampling.